In this video, you will learn how to use subprocesses and call activities in your model. Let's imagine the following scenario. We have this process for order processing, consisting of these four activities. After analyzing the process with our stakeholders, we realize that the procure the item task is more complex because it should include the following activities. One way to incorporate them is to use an expanded subprocess instead of just a single task. This is an embedded subprocess and allows you to group elements of the process. To learn more about embedded subprocesses, click the link in the top right corner. We add the expanded subprocess by dragging it from the panel, and we add all the activities in it. This extended subprocess replaces the procure items task. But now we realize that we also need a new process to manage and maintain the stock availability. So we create this new process and we call it stock maintenance. This new process also needs to utilize the procure the item expanded subprocess in cases where the item is not available in stock. The expanded subprocesses are not reusable. This means we need to simply add a new one in the stock maintenance process, and then copy and paste the same activities in it. This could work, but what happens if one day we need to change one of the activities in this subprocess? It means we need to make the modification in both the order processing and the stock maintenance process. This is why using the embedded subprocess is not the good solution in our use case, but it can work for other use cases. Let's now see a better way of doing the same thing in our use case, but this time using the call activities instead. A call activity, or reusable subprocess, allows you to call and invoke another process as part of this process. In this case, the subprocess is externalized, stored a separate BPMN diagram, and can be invoked by different processes. For more details about call activities, click the link in the top right corner. We revert to our initial process diagram, containing the procure the item task. Now, instead of adding an expanded subprocess here, we will create a separate process diagram containing the activities. We will call this diagram item procurement. Then, going back to the order processing diagram, we click the procure the item task. We then click the wrench icon and select call activity. This will allow us to link this task to the item procurement diagram we just created. Click link and select the subprocess you want to link to. Or copy the ID of the subprocess, then navigate to call activities called element property and paste the ID in the process ID text box. When the token reaches a call activity, it will wait until the subprocess is fully executed before continuing to the next tasks. We can now go to the stock maintenance process and link the exact same subprocess here as well. In this way, the subprocess becomes reusable, and if we should ever need to change something in the item procurement subprocess, we do not need to go back to all the processes to make the modification. Now let's deploy the processes and start a new instance of the order processing process. If you followed along, you pass a JSON object as follows. The item available variable set to false will ensure that the process takes the bottom path. Let's now open Operate and check the process instance. As you can see, it has completed correctly, and the procure the item call activity has been executed. By selecting this activity and clicking the called process instance link, we can access the subprocess. The subprocess has been executed as well, and the variables have been successfully passed to it. It automatically copies all variables from the parent process to the new process instance And an output mapping or output variable propagation is required to send variables back to the parent process. This concludes our demonstration. You can now start using collectivities and subprocesses in your projects.